Silverlake was built based on a model called SCIIM, which stands for Silverlake Collaborative Intelligence and Innovation Model. Now, it is a model. And of course, all models are usually mathematical. And it's based on category theory, which of course triggers many other mathematical objects. Now, if you are familiar with mathematics, it triggers many mathematical objects. Now, when you are implementing a model, a mathematical model in real world, actually it touches on economy. The issue of economy has been researched for about at least close to about 300 years since the day of Adam Smith. Obviously, if you are building a model that is economical and is quite conclusive that that the implementation will grow, right? You can't be building a model that cannot grow, right? Right. Obviously, you build a model that can grow, can multiply, and has its own life. And the fact that the word intelligence is used, the word collaboration is used, the word innovation is used. Now, Silverlake Collaborative Intelligence and Innovation Model. Now, those words are triggered. It already tells you that the potential and even the power of this model. And you know what we have done, whether it's listing in Singapore, is just one instance. In mathematics, we call it instance, or we call it an implementation. And of course, that there are many more implementations that will come along. Share price is a reflection of economic model. Now, it is a way people look at you. And you can't be happy or unhappy on what people look at you, right? Now, I can tell you that we built the model based on Silverlake Collaborative Intelligence and Innovation Model. Now, of course, that model, we evaluate the model very highly. And the fact that we are still doing about this, working on this model after 20-something years, and the fact that more and more people participated and more intelligent people get involved in the model, it tells you that many people think that it is a much valuable model than what the market perceives. But whether you like it or not, what the market perceives is what the market perceives. So it will take a while to educate the market, and it will take a while to prove to the market, right, that we deserve more. Obviously, we like to work in the same time zone, right? And if you look at the East Pacific, we are very lucky that the so-called same time zone stretches from New Zealand, Australia, up to Japan, China, and Hong Kong, and India. Now, that basically is the same time zone. Now, there is certain correlation between same time zone and efficiency and effectiveness. And it's obvious that we will focus on efficiency and effectiveness while we are still building up the company. Now, while we are still telling the world about our model, right? It will take a while before the world understand what is Silverlake Collaborative Intelligence and Innovation Model. It will take a while. While we are waiting for people to understand what we mean by Silverlake Collaborative Intelligence and Innovation Model, we ourselves set up to do our own businesses, and the fact that Asia Pacific is growing, and it's growing very fast, and it supplies sufficient ingredients for us to build and enhance or improve or even expand our business empire. Now, Silverlake axis in Singapore is about 1 billion Singapore dollar business. Now, it would be natural for us to think about 10 billion, the next digit, right, as a milestone. And we ask, how big the geographical area you need to support that 10 billion model. And Asia Pacific is more than enough to support the 10 billion business model. So meanwhile, we remain focused to try to achieve $10 billion first. Again, if I were to start with Silverlake collaborative intelligence and innovation model, obviously it does not apply just to banking or finance. And I do not want to say it applies to a specific area when I already said the ICT is moving from specific to general, right? So obviously there must be a term that we use for the next opportunity or the next potential. And that term that we use in the actual world is digital economy. Now, so what is digital economy? In the past, we sell to the banks, we sell to financial institutions. It's very obvious that banks themselves, they work with airlines, they work with retail stores, they work with supermarkets, they work with the railway, they work with governments. And I've talked about the connectivity, you know, and the collaboration that need to happen in this modern world. Right. It is not just about that it has to happen within Silverlake. Well, it happened to everyone, to the banks, to the government, to everyone. And that explains the phenomenon of social network.